My testimony tonight, second to the Lord, verses 1-2. I charge you therefore before God, Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the living and the dead and is appearing in his kingdom. Christian word, be instant in the seat, out of seat, reproof, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering and doctrine. My subject for the next few moments is I plead guilty to the new charges. In the court of law, when a crime is committed, the prosecutor decides what charges to file with any. Some cases can then go to a grand jury for a criminal indictment or to a preliminary hearing where a judge decides if there is enough evidence to proceed.
All right.
The burden of proof is often associated with the Latin phrase that I can't pronounce. But the best translation of it is, the necessity of proof always lies with the person who lays the charges.
Right.
It's not what they know, but what they can prove. So I want to touch on three familiar Bible cases real quick. First, we have the woman who was caught in adultery. Her accusers, the scribes and Pharisees, bring her to Jesus, stating that she had been caught in adultery and that the law of Moses says that she should be stoned. At first, Jesus seemingly ignores the accusers. They continue to question him, and he makes one statement. He that is without sin among you, let him first cast the stone at her. He goes back to writing on the ground. While we have no idea what he was writing, with one statement, he convicts her accusers. They leave and left is the accused and the judge. He tells her to go and sin no more. Essentially, he dropped the charges. Much like some of us, she was caught. We did it, but still guilty was the plea that was entered.
Yeah.
As we meet Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane, it's almost time for him to head to Calvary. He goes to pray, and Peter is one of those with him. When Judas and the servants and soldiers sent by the high priest approach Jesus, Peter pulls out his sword and cuts off the high priest's servant's ear. Jesus touches his ear and heals the man. Although the incident is recorded in Matthew, Mark, and Luke, Peter is not specifically named. It is said that this was done to protect him since their accounts were written while he was still alive. John, however, was written after his death, which explains him being revealed. Even in that, he was being covered. There was no evidence. They saw him do it, but they could not prove it. Just like some of us, we've done some stuff in front of people and with people. But when Jesus stepped in, they could no longer prove what they knew.
Right.
Remember, it's not what they know, but it's what they could prove.
Uh-huh.
Last, we have Calvary. It's the reason why we're all here and free.
Yeah.
It was on the cross that Jesus took our sins, canceled the debt that he did not owe. He became the propitiation for our sins. It was on the cross that he becomes our substitute, assuming our guilt and covering our sin.
Yes.
All of these instances give power to the statement, I'm not innocent, but thank God I'm not guilty.
Yeah. Yeah.